Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I am so glad. I am so glad to be a part of it and rejoice in it. There's not a day that don't go by I don't give Jesus thanks. There's not a day that's not go by I don't give him the praise. If I don't give him the glory, if I don't give him the worship every day, because Jesus is my everything. There's no other name powerful or greater than Jesus. There's nobody can do what he can do. There's nobody who can perform like he can perform. There's nobody who's sitting on the right hand of the throne like him, because he's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. He never changes like us. He never changes like the weather, and he never changes his mind. Point blank period. Our God is awesome. Our God is amazing. Our God is faithful. Our God is kind. Our God is joyful. Our God is love. Won't you try him out right now today? Because I believe right now today that somebody's worried about something. Somebody's upset about something. But one thing I know for sure, you can't praise and be worried. You can't praise and be upset. So whatever it is they got you bundled right now today, you need to open up your mouth right now today and give Jesus the thanks. You need to open up your mouth right now today and give him the glory, because there's nobody can do what he can do. I'm telling you for a fact, my brothers. I'm telling you for a fact, my sisters. You can't let the small things take you out. You got to open up your mouth and praise him. But this don't praise him because things are going good. No, this don't praise him because you got a good report today. No, you need to praise him every day, because it's going to come a time when things going to look bad. It's going to come a time when you might got to take a hit. And what you going to do? Are you going to walk away from Jesus, or are you going to praise him? Because my God stays the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. So there's no matter what time it is, there's no matter what day it is, I'm always going to open my mouth. I'm always going to thank him. I'm always going to praise him. I'm always going to glorify him. I'm always going to worship him, because who he is, because of him. That's why I'm here right now today. He gave me another chance today. He gave me another opportunity today. He blessed me my health today. He blessed my strength today. He blessed my voice today. So I'm going to thank him today. I'm going to praise him today. I'm going to glorify him today. I'm going to shout out his holy name today, because today we are victory in Jesus' name today. And if you know that you're a victory today, give Jesus some praise right now. I say, give Jesus some praise right now if you know that you're victorious today. And whoever is going through something right now today, you need to stop doing what you're doing right now today and open up your mouth, because you can't praise and worship at the same time. You can't praise and be going through something at the same time. Those don't even mix at all. And whatever it is that's bothering you right now, whatever it is that got you upset, whatever it is that got you all tangled up right now today, you need to open up your mouth and give him the praise right now today. I guarantee you, whatever it is that got you all upset, that got you in a different move, that got you in a different space right now, once you start praising Jesus for who he is, I guarantee you everything will go away. If you don't believe me, try it for yourself right now today. Amen. Our God is good all the time, and all the time he is good, and he is worthy, and he is worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. I want to say thank you to all my brothers and my sisters and every boy and girl around the world today. Thank y'all so much for being part of today's service today. Thank y'all for taking y'all time out of y'all busy schedule right now today, because y'all could have been doing anything today. You could have been watching anything else today, but you are being faithful and obedient towards Jesus' ministry today. And I just want to say thank y'all so much from the bottom of my heart. Words came in to explain how thankful I am, how grateful I am, how honored and how blessed I am. So if I'm thankful for it, and I'm grateful for it, and honored and blessed, how much more do you think our Heavenly Father God is? He is so thankful and grateful and honored and blessed because you are so faithful and obedient towards his ministry right now, that he is doing something new in your life. And if you don't believe me, turn your Bibles to Isaiah chapter 43, verses 18 through 20. He's telling you right now today that he is doing something new right now today. Do you perceive it right now today? Do you aware of it right now? Do you know for a fact that I'm doing something new, because you are faithful and that you are obedient? And I believe right now today, In the mighty name of Jesus, that was exactly what Jesus is doing for my brothers, my sisters, and every boy and girl around the world right now today. So go and get ready to receive something new that's coming your way. Go and get ready how Jesus is about to shift some things in your life right now today. This is your time. This is your year. This is your moment. 2019 going to be a year that you're going to receive some new things. I'm speaking into an existence. I'm prophesizing over it right now today. And I'm speaking over every dry bone in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for the new thing that you're about to bring our way today, Jesus. Thank you so much. Amen. 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 Glory to God. Is there anyone out there in the world today? I mean, anyone. If you are really, really ready to give your life to Christ right now today, I boldly encourage you right now today to step out on faith and please head to the altar right now today. Is there anyone right now today, you're going through something right now today? You're going through some pain, going through some suffering, you're going through a lot of depression. You've been worried a lot. You've been upset a lot. You've been crying a lot. A lot of things been against you right now today. And right now, you're at the point of your life that you can't take it anymore. You don't know what to do. You don't know where to go. And if you're going through these things right now today, I boldly encourage you right now today to please step out on faith. And please head to the altar right now today and leave that depression there. Leave that crying there. Leave that worry there. Leave that anxiety there. Leave that suffering there. And the reason I say leave it there, because according to the word of God, of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7, Jesus said that he cares for you and everything that you are going through right now today. Leave it right there and let Jesus take care of that, because there's nobody on this planet called Earth. There's nobody in this universe cares for you more than Jesus. So Jesus said, lay it on me. I will take care of that. I'll remove it. But you got to do your part by stepping out on faith and heading to the altar and leaving it there and let Jesus take care of it for you right now today. Amen. Amen. Is there anyone out there in the world today who has lost their faith, who has lost their trust, but right now that you know that you need to go back? You know for a fact there's nobody like Jesus. You know for a fact that you can't do it alone. You know for a fact that you can't move on your own. And if that's you today, please, I ask you right now today to step out on faith and head to the altar right now today. Is there anyone out there in the world today that want to be used by Jesus right now? And if you want to be used by him, but you know the consequences, please, I boldly encourage you right now today to please step out on faith and head to the altar right now today. If there's anyone out there in the world today that's been looking for a church home, you've been looking, and you've been searching, and you've been searching, but yet you haven't found anything. Yet it really touched your spirit right now, but something's telling you about Jesus' ministry right here. Something's telling that you want to be part of this fast-growing ministry. I guarantee you, if you want to be part of Jesus' ministry, all you got to do is hit this little red subscribe button right there. And I guarantee you, he'll make you feel right at home. I promise you that he will have a word, that he will have a message for you. And I promise you, as your minister, that we're going to praise together. We're going to worship together. We're going to fellowship together. We're going to pray together. We're going to have church together. We're going to do everything together. Because why? We are brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. We are one big, huge, happy family. And that's what we're going to do. If you need me to pray for somebody, let me know. If you need me to pray for you, let me know. If it's something that you want me to preach on, you let me know. You have my 100% obligation that I will do that for you, because I am your brother. Amen. Amen. I speak on this every day because there's somebody around the world each and every day that procrastinate a lot. You're not taking Jesus seriously. You are taking him for granted, and you know who you are. You like to play a lot instead of being serious. And right now, a lot of people have wondered that, because a lot of them right now today is fighting for their life in a hospital right now. But we are praying for them right now today for a speedy recovery. And I guarantee you, when they come home, they're going to take Jesus more serious. They're going to be okay, because when they get out, the first thing they're going to do is run to him. No longer procrastinating, no longer playing around, no longer acting like a child. They're going to take Jesus serious on everything. There's a lot of people who don't have that chance, who don't have that opportunity anymore, because they are dead and gone. The word of God tells us that we don't know the time or the day or the hour or something's going to happen. The Word of God also tells us that tomorrow is not promised to neither one of us. Not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, or not next year. And if you have not asked Jesus to come into your life to be your Lord and Savior Christ, today is the day that you need to confess. Today is the day that you need to open up your mouth. Today is the day that you need to make a decision. Today is the day that you need to make a move on it right now today. Quit sitting back procrastinating. Quit sitting back playing. Quit sitting back thinking who's looking at you, how they might feel about you, or you know what I'm saying, what's going on with the next person. You know what you need to do. And if you have not made that declaration right now today, please open up your mouth right now today. And all you guys say is today, Lord Jesus, that I boldly ask of you to come into our life to be our Lord and Savior Christ. And once you boldly confess that, right there and there, you're saved, you're born again, you have just accepted and received the Holy Spirit. I believe somewhere around the world today that someone just got saved. Right now today, the angels are rejoicing and praising because someone just confessed today. My brothers, my sisters, I was just like y'all at one point in time, procrastinating a lot, wasn't taking Jesus serious, playing. It got to a point I said, no, I can't play no more because I don't know what's going to happen. I can't play no more. God is waking me up for a reason. He's giving me an opportunity for a reason. So I had to take it serious. And once I boldly confessed and I took it serious, that's when Jesus was able to take it serious with me. Amen. Amen. There's a lot of people right now that you're in church with every Wednesday, every Sunday, still are lost because they still have not made that confession yet and they don't know anything about Jesus yet. But you're in church with them every Wednesday and Sunday, praising and worshiping them. Why do you think Jesus preached so much outside the temple? Because that's where the lost souls was. I'm not here to build a church. No, ma'am, no, sir. I'm here to help the lost souls. And if you need help making that decision, if you need help even confessing, let me know. We can do this thing together. Amen. Amen. My brothers, my sisters, we about to have some church today. And in this message right now today, I was reading my Bible this morning. And as I was reading, you know, the Holy Spirit was just talking to me. But as I went to work this morning, the same message and the same text that I was reading this morning, it gave me confirmation while I was at work this morning. And when he gave me the confirmation, Jesus would let me know, say, son, you need to minister on this because not only are you going through this, there's some other people who's going through the same thing too, and they really don't even know it. And today's word is when you have a different type of blessing. And when you have a different type of blessing, the enemy is going to come at you in all sorts of type of ways because your blessing is a little different. Your blessing is so powerful when the enemy knows that the enemy wants a part of you so bad. It will do anything to try to distract you. It will do anything to try to destroy you. It will do anything to wipe you right off the face of the earth. And right now, the enemy has been on the move. The enemy's been on the prowl. The enemy's been on the alert for somebody today because your blessing is a different type of blessing. But God has already sent you a helper to inform you that the enemy is on the loose. Amen. Amen. And before I get started, I always like to take the time out to give our Heavenly Father God all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Oh, Heavenly Father God, I just can't thank you enough for this awesome and beautiful blessed day today. I can't thank you enough for this word today. I cannot thank you enough for this message. I can't thank you enough for the air that we're about to breathe in. I can't thank you for the food that you have blessed and prepared our table with, the clothes and shoes that you put on our back. I just can't thank you enough that we're able to seek you today, that we're able to praise you today, that we're able to worship you today. We are able to put you first place in our life today, Jesus. I just can't thank you for our blessing today. I can't thank you for all my brothers, my sisters, every boy and girl around the world, and all the millions of people right now today that's tuning into your ministry, that's listening to your word, that's about to receive your message today. I can't thank you for our breakthrough today. I can't thank you for our healing today. I just can't thank you for our deliverance today. I can't thank you for our double portion today. I can't thank you for our more than enough today. I can't thank you for our overflow today. I can't thank you for the rain today. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. 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 I just can't thank thank you enough, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I put my faith, my trust, and my hope in you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm always glorifying you. That's why I'm always boosting about you, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just 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 can't thank you enough. In Jesus' holy mighty name, Minister LT can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do. That's why I pour my heart at you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I can't thank you enough. I can't thank you enough, Daddy. 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 I can't thank you enough. I can't thank you enough, Daddy. I can't thank you enough. Amen? Amen. I just can't thank you enough. Glory! Hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough. When you got a different type of blessing. I didn't know my blessing was that deep. I didn't know my blessing that powerful till I realized how many enemies has been on the move on me. I didn't know that my blessing was that different till I realized how the enemy has been on a prowl on me. I didn't realize that my blessing was so different till I realized how many haters that I have right now today. I just can't believe how different our blessing was, how people trying to destroy us in any kind of way. I just couldn't believe it today, Jesus. He opened up my eyes. And right now today, someone is going through this right now today. Somebody has been on the move on you. But they didn't start with you. The enemy been on your family from generation to generation, because your family have a different type of blessing. And the enemy has been attacking. The enemy has been on the move. The enemy has been on the alert, because it's someone or somebody in your family that have a different type of blessing. There's somebody in that family right now today that's stepping out on faith and saying, you know what? I'm not scared of the enemy. I'm going to step to him to let him know you took my family blessing, but you're not going to take mine, because it's something different about my blessing. And right now, the enemy has been on the prowl on you. He's been trying to do anything to take you out right now today. I don't know who I'm about to talk to right now today, but Jesus told me to tell somebody right now today, the reason why you're going through what you're going through, you have a different type of blessing. When your blessing that different right now, when you get that different type of blessing, they're going to come. They're going to come with some help too. And right now, the enemy has his posse right now today on the lurk on you. They got a hit on you. They got a want for your arrest right now today, because they're trying to lock you up and throw away the key to at the same time. But God has sent you a helper, so that won't happen. Right now, some of you don't even realize you got a helper. They didn't even realize this person was helping you. I know, because the word of God tells me so. Let's turn your Bibles to 1 Samuel 23, and we're going to read verses 17 through 18. That's 1 Samuel chapter 23, and we're going to read verses 17 through 18. And if you have your Bibles open, let the church say amen. Amen. God bless you. Don't be afraid, he said. My father Saul would not lay a hand on you. You will be king over Israel, and I will be second to you. Even my father Saul knows this. Then the two of them made a covenant before the Lord. Then Jonathan went home, but David remained at Horesh. Right now, Saul has a hit on David. And the reason why Saul has a hit on David, because David's blessing was a little different than his. And Saul couldn't take that. Saul was jealous from day one, when he realized that Saul only killed thousands, but David tens of thousands. Right then and there, he felt a certain way about David. Right then and there, he knew that David's blessing was a different type of blessing. And he wondered why his blessing was not like David. Even Saul noticed that God was with David. He was covering him. He was protecting him. He was shielding him. He was all over David, and he was not going to let anything hurt his blessing. And right now, God is over you right now today. He is covering you. He is watching you. He is protecting you. And right now, the enemy knows that. The enemy knows that your blessing is a little different from theirs. And they can't stand your guts. They don't like anything about you. They talk about you. They spread rumors about you. They're trying to set you up. They're trying to do anything to take you out right now today. They're trying to do everything to take you out. They're trying to destroy you. And they're trying to trap you. That was Saul was trying to do to David. Every time Saul thought he had David, he always sent help, said, we're going to get him this way. But no matter what David did, David always seems to escape. And the only way that David was able to escape, Saul's son, his only son, his flesh and blood, was warning him. God had sent David a helper to let him know, hey, the enemy's after you. To let him know the enemy's been after you for a long time. It didn't start with you. It started with your family before you. And after that too. It didn't start with you. Your family had that bloodline of a different type of blessing. And when the enemy know that your family got that bloodline of a different type of blessing, and you have stood up to the plate to take on the enemy, automatically, the enemy has a hit on you. Automatically, the enemy has a want for your rest. Automatically, the enemy trying to take you out. They're trying to bring you down. It's time to destroy you. But God told me to tell somebody right now today. He said, I sent you a helper. Because he said, I seize everything. I hear everything. He said, I know the plot they got against you. He said, I know the hit that they got on you. He said, I seen the want that they had on you. He said, I seen they trying to take you out. He said, I seen they trying to destroy you. He said, I see they trying to bring you down. But I'm sending you a helper right now today to let you know, to be aware that the enemy is out on the prowl on you, to let you know that the enemy has a hit on you, to let you know that the enemy don't care nothing about you. It can't stand your guts. It is disappointed about you because it thinks you don't deserve that blessing. Somebody's going through that right now today. I don't know who it is, but somewhere around the world, someone is going through this. And look who God sent as a helper. It was Saul's only flesh and blood son was the helper. Jonathan had to do this. This young man went against his father's will to say, you know what? I'm going to help this man because this man right here didn't do anything to you. This man right here has been doing everything that God has told him. He's been faithful. He's obedient. He is humble. So I'm going to protect him. I'm going to watch over him. So God sent David a helper. David didn't know this. And David, man, he probably was thinking, man, this man got his son. Now I know his son's going to get me and kill me. But when his son broke it down, he said, I'm here to help you. He said, I want to be second under you because I know that you're going to be king over Israel. Because why? David had a different type of blessing. If David didn't have a different type of blessing, do you think Jonathan would have helped David? Do you think Jonathan would have gone against his own father's will? No, he went against his father's will because he knew David's going to rule over Israel. He knew that David had a different type of blessing and he wanted to be part of that. So that's why he was able to help him. That's why he was able to get him ahead in advance. Hey, you need to elude from this territory right now today because my father has sent mans and his posse and his crew and his homeboys after you. So David was already 30 steps ahead of Saul and Saul boys and Saul crew. Because why? God has sent David a helper. And right now, God has sent somebody a helper right now today. God said, I took notice of the enemy. He said, I know the hit. I know they want rest. I know exactly what they're trying to do. They've been plotting against you at work. They've been plotting against you in your neighborhood. They've been plotting against you in your health, your dreams. And finally, they say, but I'm sending you a helper to let you know that I'm still with you, that I'm still covering you, that I'm still protecting you because you have a different type of blessing. But you got to take notice of this help that I'm sending you right now today. The help that I'm sending you right now today is informing you that the enemy don't like you. The help that I'm sending you right now today to inform you right now today that the enemy has a hit on you, that he has a want for your arrest right now today. They're trying to take you out. They're trying to get you fired from your job. They're trying to make you lose your marbles right now today. But the help I'm sending to let you know, to give you a heads up, don't you worry about that. Everything's going to be okay. And how I figured that out is, I went to work this morning, my brothers and my sisters, and I got a little weekend job, and soon I walked into work today. I spoke to my supervisor. I said, hey, how you doing? It wasn't even 30 seconds. She said, LT, they got a hit on you. Your name got an X on it. I said, okay, what I do now? They saying that you broke something. I said, well, there's no way I could have broke something because when I left work last week, everything was working fine. Everything was still in order. So how can I break something when you have three other shifts and you have nine other people doing the same thing that I was doing? So how in the world did I get blamed? And he took me right back to this text this morning and said, you got a different type of blessing. The enemy don't like you because you're blessed. The enemy can't stand you because they know that you're up next for your blessing. He knows that you're up next for your breakthrough. So right now, they're trying to do every and anything to take you out. They're trying to do every and anything to get you away from that job. But he sent me a helper. My supervisor didn't have to tell me anything this morning. She could have kept it all to herself. She could have been on the enemy's team. She could have been on the enemy's side. But God sent me a helper to inform me that they've been after me, to inform me they've been watching me, to inform me to let me know that my name has been marked. Right now, Jesus has sent somebody and a helper right now today. He sent you a Jonathan right now today. And that Jonathan that he sent you right now today is there to inform you about the enemy, how the enemy's on the move, how the enemy's been on the prowl, how the enemy has a hit on you, how the enemy has a want for your rest, how the enemy is trying to set you up and lock you up and to destroy you right now today. You wouldn't be in that position right now today, my sisters, my brothers, if you didn't have a different type of blessing. So when she told it, when she told me, she said, I'm always going to bat for you. Right then and there, she made a covenant. Her and I, we made a covenant with God. She let me know that I'm always going to bet for you because I know that you ain't doing that. Right now, you have made a covenant with your Jonathan right now today because that Jonathan want to be part of you. And the reason why that Jonathan want to be part of you, he knows and she knows that you have a different type of blessing and they want to be second. They want to be part of their victory with you. Who I'm talking to right now today. Who I'm talking to right now today. Somewhere around the world, I don't know who it is. Somebody's going through this. It can't just be only me because before me, it was week before last, the same young girl at my job was going through the same thing. So as I was talking to her this morning, I said, you're not the only one that I have a hit on you. And for a moment, she didn't understand nothing where I was coming from. So I had to break it down to her. So when I broke it down to her, I said, you have a Jonathan that's here. I have a Jonathan that's here. That Jonathan didn't have to help us. That Jonathan didn't have to save us. That Jonathan didn't have to tell us anything. But that Jonathan see that different type of blessing that you and I have. God sent that Jonathan here for a reason. Right now, God has sent a Jonathan in your life right now today. And if you have a Jonathan in your life right now today, you need to thank that Jonathan right now today to inform you, to let you know what the enemy has been plotting, what the enemy has been against, what the enemy has been prowling, what the enemy is trying to do and destroy you. Because if you didn't have a different type of blessing, there's no way that God would have sent that Jonathan in your path. Amen? Amen. So you got to pay attention to what the Jonathan is saying, because the Jonathan right now that God sent is going against everything the enemy is telling him or her to do or to you. Look what Jonathan did. He went against his own father. You would think that his son would have been on his side. But his son said, no, I'm not going to be on my father's side. For what? This man right here is a man of God. This man ain't did nothing wrong. I know he got a different type of blessing. I want to be part of that. I want to make history. I want to be on that team. I want to be established with him. And right now, you need to establish that Jonathan in your life right now today, because I have. And when I say thank you. I say, you are my Jonathan, because you didn't have to tell me that this morning. You could have kept that all to yourself. But she didn't. Right now, Jesus has sent somebody a Jonathan right now today, because God has noticed that the enemy has been on you. God has known that the enemy has put a mark on your name. He knows the enemy put a mark on your family. He knows the enemy put a mark on your finances, on your dream, on your marriage. But get ready. God's about to send you a Jonathan right now today to prevail and let you know everything what the enemy is being up against on you right now today. And if you haven't received your Jonathan yet, get ready. Your Jonathan is on the way. Amen. Amen. And if this word and if this message for you right now today, I want you to give Jesus the thanks. I want you to give him the praise. I want you to give him the glory. Because no matter how bad the enemy try to hurt you, try to set you up, long that God sent you a Jonathan, you always going to get away. You always going to be three steps ahead of the enemy. Because the enemy can do nothing to you, my brothers. The enemy can do nothing to you, my sister. The enemy is a hater, is jealous, because your blessing is a different type of blessing. And everybody don't have a blessing like what you got. Everybody didn't have a blessing like David had. Saul didn't even have a blessing like he had. Jonathan didn't have a blessing like he had. So that's why the enemy has been trying to destroy you. That's why the enemy has put a hit on you. That's why the enemy has a want for your rest, because you have a different type of special blessing, my sisters and my brothers. And if you believe that, say, I got a different type of blessing. That's why the enemy's been on me. That's why it's trying to take a hit on me. That's why it's trying to take me out. That's why it's trying to get me destroyed. That's why it's trying to get me fired from my job. That's why it's trying to get you all upset. It's because your blessing is different. That's why. You got a different type of blessing. You should be thankful for that different type of blessing. Amen? Amen. And if this word and if this message for you, give Jesus the thanks and praise and glory right now today. Before I close, can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us, so we can continue to build a relationship with you. And I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, but I was praying a simple little prayer that God is already working everything God in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is Withers.Lt. Always keep Jesus first place. Always seek him. Continue to pray for one another. And please bring somebody to church. I love y'all. Y'all stay blessed. In Jesus' holy name, God bless you. Amen.